Waiting with the British cars are Tony Bastable and Richard Hudson-Evans.
As Britain's largest manufacturer, I suppose it's appropriate, really, that British Leyland should be offering the most first-timers at Earls Court this year. Perhaps, though, of the most interest to the most potential buyers is the front-wheel drive Hydrogas Allegro, available in a number of specifications.
Making its third appearance at the show, the third bestseller overall in the UK, the Morris Marina. And to celebrate 60 years of Morris motoring, they have brought out a limited number of special Jubilee Marinas, which in fact, beneath the trimmings, are little more than ordinary 1.8 TC models.
As for Triumph, apart from the Dolomite Sprint, they just brought out this 1500 TC. Now, though it looks much the same, the front-wheel drive of the 1300 has gone. Instead, the drive now back to the rear wheels. It's claimed less power loss. However, one can't help suspecting they're saving money.
From Rover come larger 2000s, 2200s, a 10% increase in engine capacity, which apart from costing you more, does also mean slightly more performance as well as smoother running. But much more important for Leyland, it gets the car through the 1975 European exhaust emission regulations.
From our largest sports car factory at Abingdon, MG have come up at last with the obvious, putting a Rover 3.5-litre V8 motor into their MGB. But as quick as it undoubtedly is, many cynics will remember that BMC used to sell a large-engined MGB before, the ill-fated MGC.
Jaguar and Daimler XJ saloons are now Series 2, externally new grilles and higher for America bumpers, though within there's at least the added comfort of side impact protection. The dash layout completely new, the doors can be locked centrally, new air conditioning is an option. But surely destined to be most people's car of the year is the new XJ Coupe, a two-door all-British pillarless coupe whose bonnet houses either the XK-inspired 4.26 or the newer 5.3-litre 12.
Now the American-owned side of our motor industry, and starting with the most successful, Ford, and their Cortina of 18 varieties. The most popular British car choice, and now with new improvements to ride, handling and interior features, while there's a new single overhead cam 1600 engine. One additional model too, the 2000 Executive with a 2-litre overhead cam engine, as well as the seemingly inevitable vinyl roof covering, while on this one they include your radio. Escorts are much the same, although the engine from the 2000E there also finds its way into this Escort RS2000. On performance and price, between its other advanced vehicle sisters, the Mexico and the faster, more mechanically sophisticated RS1600, which continue.
Meanwhile, Vauxhall have rejigged the top end of their Viva range. They call them Magnums, whether saloon like this, estate or coupe, and the engines, 1.8 or 2.3, both overhead camshaft, while they're all in 1974 colours. The larger Victors use the same motors as the Magnums. This one, the latest VX490, is the sportiest in the range. However, who'd have thought not so very long ago that Vauxhall could have come up with anything so startlingly different in the road-going line as this, their new-look Firenza, using the 2.3-litre engine, though this time fitted with a rather special larger valve cylinder head, which owes a lot to Bill Blydenstein, and it all happened through a 5-speed gearbox. But you won't be able to get your hands on one until next year.
Next, despite their troubles, Chrysler have still managed to come up with several specification changes for next year. Some affect their best-selling Avengers. For instance, the 1500 engines have now all been upped to 1600. The power has also been increased on their 1300s, and in fact, this two-door GL is actually a new addition to their now 10-strong Avenger family.
However, thankfully, there still seems to be room for such handmade specialists as Blackpool's TVR. They produce just 10 of these 3000M Grand Tourers a week, and in spite of the red tape that restricts any car maker these days, they still manage to bring out new models. This one has a Ford 3-litre V6 engine, a glass fibre body, and beneath that a tubular steel chassis, which incidentally, just for the show, it's been announced, is now guaranteed against corrosion for 5 full years.